Hello, everyone. Today, I'm excited to show you a fantastic trick. You know that simple plastic syringe that seems to have only one use? Well, I'm going to transform it into several incredibly useful tools right before your eyes. Get ready to see a syringe go from a medical instrument to a workshop essential. Stick around to see how I do it. First, I'm disassembling a syringe by removing the plunger and the rubber stopper. Now, I'm using a utility knife to carefully trim the top of the syringe barrel. After that, I'm also trimming the small protruding part on the side where a needle would typically attach. I'm making sure the opening is perfectly flat and smooth, as this will be the new working end of our tool. To create a wider and more uniform opening, I'm using a step drill bit attached to a cordless drill. I'm gently pressing the syringe tip against the rotating bit, gradually enlarging the hole. This is going to be the housing for our new tool. Next, I'm taking a regular AA battery and carefully peeling off its outer casing. Leave a comment and let me know which country you are watching from. It's great that we can connect and chat from all over the world. Inside, you'll find a carbon rod. This rod is key for conducting electricity, and I'm using pliers to extract it. Once removed, I'm cleaning off the residue with a paper to get it ready for use. I'm attaching the carbon rod to a power drill. I'm carefully sharpening one end of the carbon rod with the drill to create a fine pointed tip. This will create a fine pointed tip, essential for what comes next. Look at that precision! To secure the carbon rod in place and strengthen the bond, I'm taking some baking soda and applying super glue to the sharpened carbon rod tip. Then, I'm dipping it into the baking soda, repeating this process several times to create a hard, durable tip. The baking soda acts as a catalyst for the super glue, making it incredibly strong. If you find this video interesting, don't forget to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell so you don't miss any interesting ideas coming soon. To turn this into a portable soldering iron, I'm going to attach a hot glue tip to the end of the carbon rod. I apply hot glue around the base of the tip, then firmly press it onto the pointed carbon rod. This provides insulation and a proper tip for soldering. I have a brass fitting. I carefully threaded it through the carbon rod. I am using a screwdriver to carefully tighten the screws. This will act as a secure attachment point. I'm taking a blue electrical wire and stripping off a portion of its insulation. Then, I twisted the individual copper strands to keep them neat. I insert one end of the stripped wire into brass joints and twist it tightly around the existing metal contacts to ensure a good connection. I threaded one end of the wire into the hollow base of the syringe and then stripped off the insulation. I'm taking a red alligator clip and attaching it to the other end of the blue wire. Next, I'm preparing an orange electrical wire in the same way and then securing a black alligator clip to its end. Now I have two alligator clips with wires for connecting to a power source. With our custom soldering tool ready, I'm preparing a power source by car battery. I'm connecting the blue wire to the positive terminal of a 12V battery and the orange wire to the negative terminal. This completes the circuit and provides power to whatever tool we connect. I'll grab a razor blade, which we'll need for some demonstration later. I'll connect the alligator clips to this battery, and then connect one clip to the razor blade. Watch closely as I touch our homemade tool to the blade. See that? It melts the metal instantly. This shows just how effective this simple tool can be for tasks like soldering. Let's try it with a copper wire. I'll connect the clip to one end. and now applying the tool. Amazing! The copper wire heats up and melts. This proves its versatility for various materials. For the final hack, I'm taking a small metal strainer. I'm connecting the black alligator clip to the strainer's handle. As I touch the carbon rod to the strainer's mesh, it heats up, turning the strainer into a portable soldering surface. I hope you enjoyed seeing these transformations and found some inspiration for your own DIY projects. Don't forget to like this video, share it with your friends, and subscribe to my channel for more exciting hacks. Thank you for your support. Bye. See you in the next video.